brothers and sisters, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
It's such a joy to gather with you to celebrate this Mass, rejoicing in the fact that Christ has been born among us, that God sends us his love so powerfully, and desires for his Son to be born within us. So let us begin in the sign of our faith, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we open our hearts before the Lord, let us call to mind our sins. And asking God's forgiveness, let us prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Your mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Created the dignity of human nature, and still more wonderfully restored it. Grant, we pray, that we may share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of him who brings glad tidings, announcing peace, bearing good news, announcing salvation, and saying to Zion, your God is King. Hark, your sentinels raise a cry. Together they shout for joy, for they see directly before their eyes the Lord restoring Zion. Break out together in song, O ruin of Jerusalem. For the Lord comforts his people. He redeems Jerusalem. The Lord has bared his holy arm in the sight of all the nations. All the ends of the earth will behold the salvation of our God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, in times past, God spoke in partial and various ways to our ancestors through the prophets. In these last days, he has spoken to us through the Son, whom he made heir of all things, and through whom he created the universe, who is the refulgence of his glory, the very imprint of his being, and who sustains all things by his mighty word. When he has accomplished purification from sins, he took his seat at the right hand of the Majesty on high, as far superior to the angels as the name he has inherited is more excellent than theirs. For to which of the angels did God ever say, "You are my son, this day I have begotten you"? Or again, "I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me"? And again, when he leads the firstborn into the world, he says, "Let all the angels of God worship him." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
With you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came to be through him, and without him nothing came to be. What came to be through him was life, and his life was the light of the human race. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. A man named John was sent from God. He came for testimony, to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came to be through him, but the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, but his own people did not accept him. But to those who did accept him, he gave power to become children of God, to those who believe in his name, who were born not by natural generation, nor by human choice, nor by a man's decision, but by God. And the Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us, and we saw his glory. The glory as of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. John testified to him and cried out, saying, "This was he of whom I said, 'The one who is coming after me ranks ahead of me, because he existed before me.' From his fullness we have all received grace in place of grace, because while the law was given through Moses, grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. The only Son, God, who is at the Father's side, has revealed him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
As we've journeyed through an Advent season, yet another Lenty Advent season, not lengthy, Lent-y, as we continue to journey through our COVID time and all the difficulties of this past year, almost 2 years. It's easy in this season, it's easy in the world that surrounds us, to lose sight of what we celebrate, to lose sight of the truth that we just heard proclaimed in the gospel. It's easy at times because we're so busy. It's easy at times because there's so many concerns that weigh upon us. It's also easy at times because when we listen to the words that God speaks to us through his gospel, if we're honest with ourselves, we don't feel worthy. If we're honest with ourselves to think that Almighty God, who created everything, who holds everything in existence, comes down to dwell in our midst, taking on our flesh, and in doing that makes it possible for us to share his own divine life, we don't feel worthy because we know our limitations. We know our sinfulness. We know the times God has called us to follow one way and we've gone precisely the opposite direction, or we haven't even moved. We know all this, and God does too. God, in fact, knows it more perfectly than we do, because again, he created us, and again, he holds us in existence. And what he does and what he proclaims to us through sending us his son, even knowing how messy we are, he doesn't come to condemn. He comes to call us to new life. He does come to call us to conversion, to set aside our limitations, set aside our woes and our fears, and to turn to him, to follow him, to live in him, as he's come to live in our midst. This is the difference. When we look at our lives, when we look at human history in our present moment, simply with our human understanding, we like neat little boxes, we like neat little categories, as though everything were finished. But God very much knows that we are works in progress. God knows he sent his son to bring us to new life. And he knows that a lot of the time we recognize Jesus, we follow him. And those moments where we stray, he knows that if we go down that path too often, it may define us. But if we wake up from our straying and come back to life, then again, he's there to cleanse us and welcome us home. There is infinite power in what we celebrate today. We don't celebrate a historical figure being born in our midst. We don't celebrate a prophet. We don't even celebrate a God among gods. There is only one God, three persons in one God. And so what we celebrate is that infinite truth. The God who is love, the God who holds us in existence out of love, wants that to be ever a more intimate and powerful experience in our lives. He wants us to move from darkness, even from twilight, to live in his light. The season of Advent purposely has slowed us down, has invited us to reflect, to renew our faith, so that when this truth is proclaimed to us at Christmas, we're ready to receive it with the joy it deserves. My brothers and sisters, as we celebrate this Mass and as we journey into the season, let us ask for the grace to do that. And let us remember that this is just the beginning. The Christmas season has many weeks ahead of us where we can sit and reflect on God's goodness, on God's love, on the many things he does for us, and the many, many times he has been willing and will be willing to welcome us back to his loving embrace, to that communion he calls us to. The light has come. Let us open our eyes. Let us welcome that light to dwell in our midst. And most importantly, let us rejoice. Merry Christmas. Let us together profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Rejoicing that God is with us, let us present him with our prayers.
For the Church, the body of Christ in the world, may God bless her efforts to share the good news with others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations, may the gospel message of peace inform their work for justice in the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are estranged from family, the church, or society, finding reconciliation and profound healing, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and religious life in the Archdiocese of Boston, that more men and women will respond with generosity to the call to serve God in religious vocations, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all the baptized may grow in appreciation and love of Christ's gift to us of his real presence in the Eucharist, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For the intention of this Mass, the people of the Catholic parishes of Stoughton, for all who have died, for the souls in purgatory, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the prayers and intentions which each of us brings to this Mass in the silence of our hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And as we journey into this Christmas season and into the coming year, let us pray for St. James and Immaculate Conception parishes, for all who worship here, for all who worship at a distance, and for all those whom God is calling to join these worshiping communities. They may be beacons of hope and faith to the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and merciful God, we thank you and praise you, because you love us so deeply and perfectly, and you continually invite us to enter into this love. We ask your help and ask your grace to respond to you as generously as you have come to encounter us. We thank you for the gift of your Son, born in our midst, who, taking on our flesh, gives us a share in your divine life. We ask you to hear our prayers and to answer them through Jesus Christ, who is your Son and our Lord, and through the intercession of his Blessed Mother. Together we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Thank you.
sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Make acceptable, O Lord, our oblation on this solemn day, when you manifested the reconciliation that makes us wholly pleasing in your sight, and inaugurated for us the fullness of divine worship through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just,
our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones, dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your Son, of your Church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint James and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Sean Patrick, our bishop, and his assistant bishops, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you've gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you've summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you with their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Rejoicing in the birth of our Lord, let us pray as he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Grant, O merciful God, that just as the Savior of the world born this day is the author of divine generation for us, so he may be the giver of even of immortality, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Before we pray our collaborative prayer and the final blessing, just on my behalf, on behalf of Father Duardo and Father Ixon, whom I'm blessed to serve with here, on behalf of our deacons and our staff, I want to wish you and all your loved ones a very happy and blessed Christmas. It's my second Christmas here as your pastor, and every day I am grateful to God for the opportunity to serve such wonderful communities. Know of my prayers for all of you, and know that I count on your prayers as well. Let us pray. Almighty and living God, you have called us to be disciples of your Son, Jesus, and to labor building up the church in Stoughton. We ask the intercession of our patrons, St. James and the Blessed Virgin Mary, That through their example, you may teach us to follow you more faithfully each day. May we follow St. James in seeking to follow Jesus wherever he leads us. May we follow Our Lady's instruction to do whatever Jesus tells us. Transform us through your Holy Spirit to be faithful and fruitful stewards of your many gifts. Help us to live lives marked by faithful prayer, service to our neighbor, and generous sharing. We pray through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying God by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
And have a great week and a Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.